Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thanks to the moderator and hello dear all participants of International Bioprocessing Association Subject Conference. My name is Wawan Agustina. I am from Research Center for Applied Technology in National Institute of Sciences. I will present my paper with the title of Microbriquettes from Sugar Palm Dregs Fiber, Cassava Dregs, Coconut Shell Charcoal with Solid Substrate Premixture Technology. The next, here is the outline of my presentation, introduction, research purposes, literature review, materials and method, research and discussion, conclusion and reference. The first is introduction. We know that biomass waste such as cassava dregs, sugar palm dreg fiber, and coconut shell can be used as a source of alternative energy raw materials. Cassava dregs is one of the solid waste from the production of cassava starch. Sugar palm dregs fiber is a solid waste material from the production of palm sugar starch. And coconut shell is a waste material from the use of coconut, which is then processed into charcoal by pyrolysis. We know that supplementation technology, we can produce solid biomass product such as a microcomposite. And based on this, we tried to make a solid product by utilizing solid waste materials using mushroom mycelium as an adhesive. The next is research purposes. The purposes of this study was to obtain a product in the form of microbriquettes and their characteristic from the main raw materials of cassava dreg, sugar palm dreg fiber, and coconut shell charcoal by fermented using Ganoderma lucidum. The next is literature review. Okay, the first is cassava dregs. Solid waste from cassava processing into tapioca is about 2/3 of the amount of cassava used. About 10% of cassava solid waste is a cassava dregs, or we call it onggok, which is a carbohydrate in the form of cellulose. The fiber in cassava pulp consists of hemicellulose, pectin, and cellulose. The next is sugar palm dregs fiber. The chemical composition of sugar palm dregs waste is about 60.61% of cellulose, 15.74% of hemicellulose, 14.21% of lignin, 7.87% of moisture content, 0.57% of reducing sugar, and 1% others. The next is coconut shell charcoal. The previous research saw that coconut shell charcoal have a density of 0.76 gram per cc, a water content of 0.038%, as content of 1.47%, and fixed carbon content of 97.03%. A coconut shell charcoal is widely used as a raw material for active potent charcoal and charcoal briquette. The next is materials and methods. The first materials. The materials we use consist of raw materials, chemicals, and also tools and laboratory equipment. The raw materials we use were sugar palm dregs fiber, cassava dregs, coconut shell charcoal, rice bran, and a culture of Ganoderma lucidum. And then for chemicals and tool and laboratory equipment, like you can see in my presentation screen. The next is methods. This study was consists of five main stage. The first is material pre-treatment, and then inoculum preparation, manufacturing of microbriquette quality testing based on industry standard, and the last is optimization of microbriquette manufacturing and quality testing. The next is formula and treatment. This study consists of two stage of treatment. Namely preliminary treatment and also optimization treatment. The preliminary treatment consists of preparation based on compression between sugar palm dregs fibers and also cassava dregs with the variation of BRA, BRB, and BRC, where BRA with the compression 65 to 35, and BRB 50 to 50, and BRC 35 to 65. And then in the optimization treatment, also cost of preparation. The basic formula used is a selected formula from previous treatment, namely BRC. In this treatment, we use a coconut shell charcoal as a substitution for a mixture of sugar palm rex fiber and also cassava rex. We use substitution with the amount of BRCA, BRCB, and BRCC, each of 10%, 15%, and 20% respectively. The next is step of micro briquette production. The step of micro briquette production is consists of five main stage. The first is preparation of production medium, and then inoculum production, and then inoculum and fermentation, and then pressing and drying, and the last is cutting and packaging. Here is the picture of micro briquette production process. The next is result and discussion. The first is raw material characteristic. In the table 2, you can see the characteristic of raw materials used in this study. The next is micro briquette product. In the left side, you can see the picture of appearance of micro briquette product. And then we also can see the result of characterization from the micro briquette product, and compare it with standard. From the treatment BRA, BRB, and BRC, we can see no significant difference among them, except for the density. And from this table, we can see that the result is indicate only water content parameter have met the standard. But for the next treatment or for optimization process, we use a BRC formula as a selected formula due to its highest density. The next is optimization result of micro briquette product. Here you can see the picture of micro briquette product after optimization, and then we can see the table. The characteristic of micro briquette after optimization. In this table, we can see the green cell and also the cell with a red outline. The green cell is indicates that value has met the initial standard for wood pellet, and the outline red indicate that the value has the best value compared to the standard. And from this optimization, we can understand that there were significant characteristic change in all parameter except of moisture content. The characteristic of moisture content, color peak value, volatile matter, and fixed carbon have met the Indonesian standard for wood pellet. However, although there was a decrease in the value of ash content and increase in the density value, these two parameters didn't meet the Indonesian standard for wood pellet. And the best formula is the BRC formula with the addition of 20% of coconut shell charcoal. The next is conclusion. From this study, we can conclude that a micro briquette product can be made from sugar palm rex fiber, cassava rex, and coconut shell charcoal with solid substrate fermentation technology using gun dermolucidum. The step of micro briquette production include materials and inoculum preparation, materials mixing, sterilization, inoculation, fermentation, pressing, drying, cutting, and packaging. And the best formula of the micro briquette is the BRCC formula with addition of 20% of coconut shell charcoal. And the micro briquette product have met the industry standard for wood pellet, except for the ash content and density. And here is the reference. And this is the end of presentation. I would like to say thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.